so those are out that way. There are also restrooms through that door. You have to walk up 3 or 4 steps, and they're just to the right. Okay, so those are your options for that. It is a thrill to have all of you here. Are you ready to sing?
Yes.
Do you know Jennifer Fry?
Yes.
Raise your hand if you're a friend of Jennifer. That's an F-O-J. This is Jennifer Fry. Give her a welcome.
Please
give a warm welcome to Larry Shackley.
entrance to my room, a great play. It's really nice to play with someone who has a lot of musicality in it, and it actually keeps the expression marks and stuff. Kind of thing with partners who is just like kind of forte all the way through. But if you have pianos in your church, especially with four hands, check out the books. There's a lot of fun music in there. We're going to do another one this afternoon. But anyway, we're here to sing. So let us open up the first piece, Holy God, We Praise Your Name. This was one of the first pieces that I arranged my team on staff at Lorenz. And it's a hymn that I remember singing when I was growing up, but for some people it doesn't seem to be that well known. But it's a great hymn for, well, it has a lot of different possibilities. I think it is a Trinity piece, but there's all sorts of other possibilities for it. There's a spring of this camp on page 7, so if you are at this camp, you can think about that. This has a nice organ accompaniment. We're going to do it with the piano, and Jeff's going to play the trumpet for us, so let's read it through. I brought a baton today. I had rotator cuff surgery last year, so I'm trying to avoid doing the Leonard Bernstein kind of stuff. So. turn to a spiritual by Victor Johnson. Victor's now editing with Forrester's Guild, and it's a beautiful arrangement of a spiritual. This is also available in two-part version. I know that some of you have a lot of pieces in the room today are SATB, but some of you have smaller choirs, so I'll try to remember to mention when we have pieces that are in alternate voices. But we're going to sing the four-part version because that's more fun. And now they told me, because we had so much music to go through, they told me that I could do my pieces all the way through, but that I could make cuts and so on. So don't think that I'm doing it because I'm like, arrogant. I was instructed. So we'll do as much as we can. We'll skip around. Maybe let's hear the beginning. Victor writes just gorgeous piano parts.
Thank you.
this takes the, not only is the venue angle in here, as you'll see, but also based on the old Wally Wally tune, the beautiful folk tune that's been used for a lot of different texts. But Mary just created a beautiful, fresh idea. There's an optional cello part, and our cello opted not to come today. So, no, that's a good thing. There's a beautiful cello part, but just for now, if we could just start at measure 9 at the bottom of the page, the first page, and then the ladies will begin on the top of 3.
Thank you.
The orchestration is also very different. Joel is such a fine piano player. His parts are always a lot of fun. And again, this is a piece that, you know, congregations enjoy, and this just helps them to hear it in a new way. Jennifer picked for today is that it's not all brand new music. She picked out some older pieces that need to have a new look because it's been a long time since they were out. Away in the Major by Paul Scholin. That's a good Swedish name, you know. I'm half Swedish, so I don't know who speaks so. Let's see this one very sensitively. I'll tell you what, I'm going to start. Oh, we have a flute part. We have to do the whole thing. It's not like our musical guitar player. We actually have a real flute. So let's just sing the whole thing. So I know that, you know, other people who are more, you know, save all of those for the end. There's so many good ones. Mary McDonald has, over the last 2 years, commemorations of some of the favorable Bill and Gloria Gaynor songs. She's done quite a few for the friends. This one's from Hope. And it brings in their old song, Let's Just Praise the Lord, from back in the 70s, 1972. I remember that was a new song. But Mary has written a whole new piece to go around with it. So by the time you get Let's Just Praise the Lord, it's like, oh, that's what this piece is. So we start with Mary's new material. This has an optional rhythm section. This is also available in SAB or SATB. Do we have bass on this one, Jennifer?
What?
Do we have bass? Oh, I know all the top people when we're here. This is Eric. Eric Stratton is playing bass for us. And so there is a whole rhythm section thing. There's a fiddle. It's a very Americana kind of feel, folky kind of feel. I guess you started at the end too.
Yeah.
All right. I'll give you three. One. Seeing the Lord, gospel style. So that's what we did. We have a gospel flavored version of Basic Shape. Although in the middle of it, you do go to some straight lead notes. You'll see that when we get there. Does everybody know this song, Basic Shape? I see some yeses and some no's. Okay, what do you know?
My bike over to the church, but
Carl Schott is, of course, a very well-known Lutheran world, but his music has transcended to all sorts of concerts. And I watched a YouTube video of the Georgia Boys Choir doing this piece, and it's just lovely. And I'm sure that people also do it in a lovely manner. It's an interesting, now look at the lyrics are by Yaroslav Veda. You know where he's from? Lorain, Ohio. So this one you have to play like, you have to sing like you're a string player. Just very, very, very smoothly. It's in two, so it's going. It's just chords. Let's hear it. Actually, this song is addressed to the angels. There aren't too many